Good morning. Welcome back to KU2 Nausanabagh Visakhapatnam grammar classes. Today's lesson is about past tense. As you all know that there are mainly three types of tenses: present tense, past tense and future tense. So today I will explain you about past tense. What is past tense? Past tense means it is used for actions, habits and repeated events that happened in the past. This past tense is used for actions, habits and repeated events that happened in the past. That is called past tense. This past tense is further divided into four kinds. What are those? That is simple past, past continuous, past perfect and past perfect continuous tense. These are the four sub kinds of past tense. Today, very clearly I'll explain you about simple past, its structure and uses. Now we will see what is simple past when it is used. Simple past is used for the completed actions, habits and repeated events that happened in the past and are now completed or over, will not be continued further. Those are called simple past sentences. This simple past is used for the completed actions, habits and repeated events that happened in the past. It will not be continued further. That is called simple past. So for simple past, often we had to use V2 form, verb, second form. Simple present, we have used V1. Simple past, we had to use V2 form. And also, we can use adverbs of time for this purpose to make the time more clear. The adverbs used for this purpose are yesterday, last day, last year, sometime back, ago, etc. These are used to indicate the simple past tense. These are the some of the adverbs of time. Is it clear? Now we will see structure and uses. We'll see the structure first. What is the structure of simple past tense? The structure of simple past tense is subject plus V2 plus object. V2 means verb second form. Simple present tense is subject plus V1 plus object. Simple past tense is subject plus V2 plus object. So here I have given three examples of V1, V2, V3. Help, helped, help. Go, went, gone. Do, did, done. These are the three forms of these verbs. So often for simple past, we had to use V2 form. We'll see the example now. They helped me. They, subject, helped V2, me. Nothing else will be there here. And now no helping verb, nothing, only subject plus V2 plus object. This is the structure of simple past. Now, as usually, we will discuss these three types of sentences in simple past also. What are those three types of sentences? Already I have told you that those are affirmative sentences, negative sentences and interrogative sentences. Affirmative sentences means positive sentences that do according to the structure. For example, I fulfilled my promise. I fulfilled V2, my promise. It is according to the structure, subject plus V2 plus object. Another one is, we went to a restaurant. We, subject, went, V2, to a restaurant is an object. So, we went to a restaurant. This is also according to the structure. So, these are called affirmative sentences. Here, helping verb is not needed. Helping verb is needed to make negative sentences as well as interrogative sentences also. Now, what is the helping verb is used in simple past to make negative sentences? Usually not is added, isn't it, for making negative sentences. But what is the helping verb is used? So, helping verb to make negative sentences in simple past is did. In present tense, we will use do or does. But in past tense, to make negative sentences and interrogative sentences, we had to use did as a helping verb. So, the structure for making negative sentences in simple past is subject plus did plus not plus V1 plus object. Often, V1 comes after did. V1 comes, remember this, did not go. Often, V1 comes with did, remember this. So, for example, I did not like his behavior. I did not like his behavior. I did not like V1. His behavior is
object. So often V1 comes with did. Did helping verbs comes in simple past for negative sentences. Not is added to make negative sentences. Remember these points often. Now, you may have one doubt that with which subjects we had to use did. Because in simple past, I have told you that do, the helping verb used with I, we, you, they. And does is used with he, she, it, isn't it? But in simple past, with all the subjects, I, we, you, they, he, she, it, we had to use the helping verb only did. With all the subjects, the helping verb did only comes. Now, interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences means questions. So, the helping verb is did. Already I have told you that we had to take the helping verb did to make negative and interrogative sentences in simple past. So, with all these subjects, I, we, you, they, he, she, it, only did comes in simple past. Now, as usually for interrogative sentences, we had to use this helping verb at the beginning of the sentence. We had to write this helping verb at the beginning of the sentence and followed by subject. Now, we will see some examples. Did the teacher control his class? Did comes at the beginning of the sentence and followed by the subject. V1 comes control. Did the teacher control his class? Often V1 comes with did. Another example is, did I eat? Eat is in V1 because did. With did we had to use V1. Did I eat all my food? This is another example for interrogative sentences. Now, we will see the uses of simple past. What is the first usage of simple past? Means, first one is action that happened in the past and to report completed actions. It is used often in recounts and narratives. This is the first usage of simple past. Simple past is used with the actions that happened in the past and to report completed actions. And also, it is used often in recounts and narratives. For example, the movie started at 6 p.m. It is a completed action, so that we had to use simple past. He ate too much at the party. He ate too much at the party. We discussed the matter seriously. We discussed. It is a completed action. We discussed. Listen, this is very important to remember that after discuss, we should not use about. We discussed about. It is wrong. About should not be used with discuss. We discussed the matter seriously. This is the first usage of simple past. Now, the next usage of simple past is to indicate past habits are repeated events. We can use simple past tense. Simple past tense is used to indicate past habits are repeated events. We had to use simple past tense. So, see, for example, I always rode a bike to school when I was young. I always rode a bike to school when I was young. So, always, I always rode, V2 form, a bike to school when I was young. It shows the past habit. Often, it's a habit in the past. So, it should be in simple past. Another example, she wanted to be alone always. It is her habit, that is in the past. She wanted to be alone always. Another example, during exam days, I studied 10 hours daily. During exam days means in those days, I studied 10 hours daily, but not now. Is it clear? This is another usage of simple past. Here I have given a note. What is that? So often we are using V2 form, isn't it? In simple past. But instead of V2 means verb second form, we can use used to. We can use used to plus V1 instead of V2. Used to plus V1 we had to use to write the sentences in simple past instead of using V2. For example, Indira Gandhi used to work 18 hours a day. Indira Gandhi used to work 18 hours a day. Past action that too. Instead of V2, we have used used to work. Used to plus V1. So, instead of V2, we had to use used to plus V1. Another example. He used to walk 20 kilometers a day. He used to walk. It is a past event action, isn't it? But not now. At present, it is not going on. He used to walk 20 kilometers a day, but not now. So, often we can use used to plus V1 instead of V2. It is another rule. You can use it. So, in those days, another example we can see. In those days, everybody used to be sincere. In those days, but not now. Everyone is not at all sincere now. Next, some hints I will give you to identify the tense, that too simple past. For example, these are the words you can see in those sentences to identify the simple past sentences. Ago, long ago, back, long back, then, yesterday, last night, in 1947, in 1974, like this. All these are the keywords to identify the simple past tense. These words indicate that the sentences belong to simple past, that is V2. Is it clear? Once again, I'll show these 2 points, the uses of simple past, that is, one is action that happened in the past and to report completed actions. It is used often in recounts and narratives. The second one is to indicate past habits or repeated events. We can use simple past tense. Note. This is note. Instead of V2 verb second form, we can use used to plus V1. This is about simple past tense. Past tense. Tomorrow in the next video, I'll explain you past continuous. Thank you.